So having successfully completed the three units of the subject data structure, we are now entered into, we are now going to enter into fourth unit. The fourth unit deals with a new data structure called a graph. It is also a non-linear data structure. The various topics that are going to be dealt under this unit are definition, representation, types of graph, operation performed in the graph like traversal and sorting. With respect to traversal, it is a breadth first and depth first traversal. With respect to sorting, it is a topological sorting. And apart from that, there are additional concepts are also we are going to study, that is biconnectivity, cut vertex and Euler circuit. So these are the additional concepts that we are going to see in the fourth unit. Finally, application of graph. So these are the topics that we are going to see in the fourth unit. So as compared with the all the three units, first unit, second unit and the third unit, this is very very smaller unit, and it can be easily understood, and it can be easily finished, and it is very easier to follow also. Among the three units, the third unit is very bigger unit, and the content is also very vast, but it is very easier to understand and very easier to remember the ideas, like a playway method, creating a node, plugging the node, taking out the node, searching the node, traversal and so operations. Likewise, this unit is very simpler and very easier to understand, and it is you can learn the things in a very playway method, like the concepts are very easier to understand. So let me go into the topic. So to start with, as usual, I said to you that whenever you study a data structure, first of all, you should know the definition of this data structure. Then you should know how diagrammatically it is represented. Third, you should know what are the representations that are available. So in general, representations are, one is array representation, another one is point representation. Likewise, in graph also, we have two representations. Then you should study about ADT. Under ADT, you should study about various operations, various operations. Then finally, any special kind of data structure is available. That is, with respect to graph, any special kind is available or not. And finally, you should study the applications. So in the seven topics, is mostly most important topic for every data structure one has to remember. The yellow topic that you remember over in the data structure. So and the way, so when we go to graph data structure, so graph is a non-linear data structure. Is my screen visible? Yes. So graph is a non-linear data structure. What is mean by non-linear data structure? Here, the data is stored in a non-linear manner. Non-linear manner. When you see a logical representation of the graph, the data is stored here and there. Some kind of non-linearity is followed. But when you look at the physical memory, the data is linearly available. But when you want to choose a particular data, you should go in a non-linear manner in order to access an element, that is a random manner only. Like your tree data structure that represents hierarchical relationship, this graph data structure, what it represents? Geographical relationship. Geographical relationship. That is, whenever you want to denote a map like data, which contains a selection of collection of cities and the routes connected by the city, connected between the cities, those are the kind of information that can be represented by a graph. So the parent-child relationship is there with the tree, whereas the city and its associated connection, like a relationship, that is a geographical relationship, is with the graph. Mathematically, a graph is represented as two terms. One is V, another one is E. What is mean by V is, V represents vertices, or otherwise it is called by the name nodes, or it is set as set of vertices, like V1, V2, V3, V4, V5, like that it goes on. What is E is set of edges. You may call it as edges, or you may call it as lines, or you may call it as arc. So it is nothing but a line connecting two vertex. So if you want to say the set of edges in V, then it is represented as V1 comma V2. That means, yeah, there is a connection between V1 and V2. V1 and V3, that is, there is a connection between V1 and V3. V3 and V2, there is a line between V3 and V2. V4 and V5, there is a connection between V4 and V5. So in that way, you have to represent the graph mathematically. So a graph is represented mathematically using two concepts. One is set of vertices, another one is set of edges. Next, how it is represented physically? Physically, so diagrammatically, a graph is represented like this. So it is represented with a node. The node contains the key value or the data, and each node is connected by a line that is called arc. See, for the given graph, V is nothing but set of vertices. So what are the vertices here? The nodes that are circled, which contains the data, are called vertices or nodes. So what are the vertices? A, B, C, D, E. They are all vertices. So vertices are represented. What are the edges? The lines connecting the vertices. So AB, there is a line. So AB is one edge. AC is another line. So AC is having another edge. And what is that? AD, BE, CE, D, E, like that, everything. See, there is no more edge available with the edge CB. CB negiyadirka? No, because there is no connection. There is no connection. So likewise, the edge represents the set of connections. So in this way only, you need to represent the graph. Represent the graph. So this is a diagrammatic representation. This is mathematical notation. Mathematical notation. So what is vertex? So vertex is a one called by the name node that contains a data. Either it contains a data or it contains key elements, key value. When you come to edge, edge is a line connecting the vertex. The vertex may be of different kinds. It may be a directed line. So how it is, say the direct presence of arrowhead. If there is an arrowhead is there, then it is a directed line. If no arrowhead is there, then it is an undirected graph. And if that line carries some value over the line, so if there is an arrowhead, then it is a directed. If the line consists of some values, then it is called weighted. Right? So that is the distinction between direction and weight. So accordingly, the graph is directed graph. A directed graph, there should be arrow. Over the arrow, if you have value, then it is a directed weighted graph. If there is no value, then it is a directed unweighted graph. If there is no arrow, and it is simply a line, then it is undirected. If there is any value over it, then it is undirected weighted graph. So likewise, you can say the differences of a graph with respect to the line. That means with respect to the edge. So accordingly, the graphs are, see, this is a directed graph. Why it is called a directed graph? Because the edge is an arrow. The edge is an arrow and it is giving some kind of direction. This is undirected graph because the edge doesn't have any arrow, so it doesn't show any connection. What is weighted graph? Whether the edge is having arrow or not, if the edge is associated with some numerical values, the numerical values are in general called by the name weight. So what is the value inside the node? The value inside the node is called by the name either data or key. But what is the value over the edge? It is called the over the edge mele irukkuri and the values on the other weight. So this graph is called weighted graph. So again, the weighted graph can be divided into directed weighted graph, underwritten vector graph. See, if there is a value here, 5, 2, 3, 1, then it is a weighted directed graph. If there is a value here, 2, 1, 5, like that, then it is weighted underwritten graph. So accordingly, the type goes up. Next, terminologies. Like the tree data structure, here also we have terminology. The most important terminology one should remember is path. Path. So what is path? A line connecting all the edges along its line of travel. So that is path. So A, B, C are connected in this, connected with one another by a line. So it is a path. But when you take H, K, and what is it? C. There is no line. There is no line from H to K and K to C. So then it is not a path. So it is not a path. Since there is no line, this is not a path. What about path in a directed graph? A path in a directed graph should be in the one direction. See, this arrowhead is in another direction. This arrowhead is in this direction. So this is a path now. Suppose if that arrow is like this direction, then ABC is not a path. Because C, remember, from A to G, there is no path. Because G to A is a path. So A, G and K is not a path. A, G and K is not a path. So you should remember that. So what is a path? A line joining all the nodes. If you start from a node, then you end at the node, then the line connecting all the nodes in between the source node or destination node, or in between the starting node or ending node, are going to be called as the path. Provided you should have a line in between them. In case of directed graph, the arrow should be in one direction. Then only you can treat that is a path. If the arrow is present in the reverse direction or in the opposite direction, then you need not say that it is a path. Right? So these are the few one kind of terminology. Likewise, another terminology is cycle. What is cycle is, say for example here in this graph, the starting node is A. If you choose starting node is A, then from A it goes to B. The arrow is here like this. From B, the direction goes to C because the arrow is like this. From C, you can go to G. The arrow is like this in that direction. From G, you can go come to A again. That is, the source node as well as the ending node are all is same. In that case, you wish to establish a cycle. You wish to establish a cycle. That graph is called cyclic graph. Cyclic graph. So in order to trace a path from node A to node A, not a self flow. So this is also one path, but it is a self flow. But node A irukku appadina. So if it is start from A and again ends at A, if it is, this is called self loop. Self loop. So it is not the case. It is not the case here. So it is starting from A, it is starting from A, going to B, then coming to C, then coming to G, then coming to A. So the arrow is like that. Arrow is like that. So this is called a cycle. This is called a cycle. So this kind of graph is going to be called as cyclic graph. If a graph doesn't contain such cycle, the graph is cycle illenu vechukonga, this kind of cycle illa, this kind of pattern you are not observing in the given graph, then the graph is called acyclic graph. That is a graph without cycle. A graph without cycle is called a acyclic graph. So that is the idea. Here also you can say that cyclic graph, the cyclic directed weighted graph. So you can say that why it is called cycle, because when you choose a node and if that node travels to every other node and finally comes to the original node or a starting node, then it is said that a path, and that path is closed, and that closed path is called as cycle. What is meant by direction? Presence of arrowhead from one node to another node indicates that you should go only in that direction of the arrowhead. Then that graph is called directed graph. What is meant by weighted graph? If a edge is associated with some value over the connection or over the line between the two nodes, then it is going to be called a weighted graph, right? So another terminology that you wish to see is a degree. So same thing, you can find it in tree also. So in case of graph, you need to say the number of edges incident on a vertex. Say for example, this is one vertex, this is one vertex, and this vertex is A. So if this is this is direction, means so all are treated as degree. When it is coming for directed graph, then you need to say the degree in two values, in degree and out degree. Say for example, this A, the arrow head is like this. Then how many arrows are going outward from A? This is one and this is another one. So there are two out degrees. How many arrows are coming inside? This is one and this is two. There are two in degrees. So number of edges coming to the vertex is called in degree. Number of edges going out from the vertex is called out degree. So according to the definition varies. If you look at this graph, take the node 0. How many edges are there? One edge, two, and this is three. So that is three. Very good. Likewise, for each node, you can find three edges. So the degree of the given node in this particular graph is three. Right. See, my dear students, what is this? My question here is whether it is a graph or tree. Can anyone say the answer? Is it tree or like graph? Look at it. Can anyone say the answer? Is it a tree or a graph? No one? Okay. Let me give you an answer. Any tree or all tree can be treated as a graph, provided you should forget about the root element. So idhu da root element sollama, if you drew a tree, then you may say that the tree is a graph. And if a tree consists of a cycle, if I say for example I am drawing a tree, so this is tree, I am saying that this is tree. So A, B, C. If I say A is the root node, then this is going to be a tree. If I didn't say A is the root node, then this is going to be a graph. Likewise, see, and there is another one. This is A, this is B, this is C. Here, I am saying this is the root. A is the root. Is the root in children. But B ki C ki adela or connection vandirukku, whether it is a tree? It is not a tree. It is not a tree because it is having cycle. It is having a closed loop. So a graph without a closed loop and with the indication of root node is a tree. இப்ப இங்க பாத்தீங்கன்னா உங்களுக்கு பார்க்கும்போது இது எப்படி தெரியுது? ஒரு ட்ரீ மாதிரியாவே தெரியுது. ஏன்னா இது டாப்ல இருக்கிற மாதிரி இருக்கு, அதுக்கு அடுத்த லெவல்ல இருக்கிற மாதிரி இருக்கு, இது அடுக்கத்துல ட்ரீ மாதிரியே இருக்கு. பட் ஹியர் நோ ஒன் இஸ் சேயிங் தட் ஜீரோ இஸ் த ரூட் நோட். ஜீரோ இஸ் த ரூட் நோட் நம்ம சொல்லல. ஜீரோ இஸ் த ரூட் நோட் நம்ம சொல்லாத வரைக்கும் இது என்னதான் வந்து? கிராஃப் தான். அப்ப இந்த கிராஃப்ல ஜீரோக்கு எத்தனை டிகிரி இருக்கு? ரெண்டு டிகிரி. ஒன்னுக்கு எத்தனை டிகிரி இருக்கு? நீங்க பைனரி ட்ரீனு இதை எடுத்துக்கிட்டீங்கன்னா how many number of degree for one? 2 degrees nu solluvanga, but it is not a tree. Moreover, it is not a binary tree. Appo one ku ethana branch irukku? idu or branch. For number 1 or for vertex 1 you have 3 degrees. Likewise for vertex 2, for 3 1, like that. But when you take this as a tree, three ki pathina, since there is no branch and this three is treated as a leaf node at a degree epovume vandu pathina zero nu irukum, right? But this is a graph. Can anyone understand the idea, or do you have any doubt? Do you want me to explain again? Yes. Okay. So consider this graph. Consider this graph. So here for this node 0, the in degree is 1, out degree is 1, because one arrow is going outside. So it is out degree 1, and one arrow is coming inside, that is in degree. For this node, one arrow is coming inside and one arrow is going outside. So this is for this. So two arrow is going outside. So this is one arrow and this is one arrow. So that is in degree is 1, out degree is 2. This is 1 and this is 2. And for this node 2, in degree is 1 and out degree, there is no edge arising out of it. In case if there is a edge like this, if there is a edge like this, then the out degree might be 3. Since there is no such degree, you may treat this as a out degree as 0. So this is the terminologies that you should remember while studying the graph, right? So remember, students, a tree and a graph both have the same meaning. So to make the difference, the circle with the data element or key element is treated as a node in tree, and it is called as vertex in graph. But that is not an actual difference. That is not an actual difference. Likewise, the thing that connects two nodes is called by the name edge. Edge here, or it is otherwise called by the name arc, A-R-C, arc. Or simply, you can say that line. Line. But in case of tree, that is called as branch. Left side, right side branch, like that. There is a branch coming out, giving right to you a child node like that, right? Representation of graph. So in tree, you have two representation. One is linear or sequential representation, that is array representation. Another one is linked or pointer representation. Likewise, linked list also, linked list, list also, array representation of list, pointer representation of list. Likewise, graph also, you have array representation. This is array representation. Array represent, this is pointer representation. So the array representation is represented in forms of a two-dimensional array, 2D array. About 2D array, in what name you have to call? You have to call it by matrix. So pointer representation, it is a list like representation. But this is a graph, Abdina. In the graph, on the set of vertices, எப்படி எழுதுவோம்? V எப்படி எழுதுவோம்? V is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. இந்த மாதிரி. How to calculate edge? Edge பார்த்தீங்கன்னா 1 to 2 கடையில் ஒரு கனெக்ஷன் இருக்கு. So 1 to 2 is one edge. And 2 to 3 is one edge. And 1 to 4 is one edge. And 3 to 1 is one edge. And 4. So first, finish the 1. Starting node. Starting node 1 ல இருந்து 2 க்கு ஒரு edge. அப்புறம் 1 ல இருந்து 4 க்கு ஒரு edge. 1 ல இருந்து வேற எதுவும் இல்லை. Then 2 choose the 2. 2 ல இருந்து 3 க்கு மட்டும் தான் ஒரு edge. அதுக்கப்புறம் எதுவும் கிடையாது. Next 3. 3 ல இருந்து 1 க்கு ஒரு edge. Next 3 முடிஞ்சு 3 ல இருந்து வேறது கிடையாது. Next 4 எடுத்தீங்கன்னா 4 ல இருந்து 2 மட்டும் தான் ஒரு edge. So likewise, you should define the set of edges. This is for logical representation of the diagram as well as the mathematical representation of the vertex and the edge. But when you go for implementing the graph in computer memory, you have to represent. So for this graph, there are how many nodes? Four nodes are there. So you have to represent as a two-dimensional matrix in which rows and column represents the node value. So that is node 1, node 2, node 1, node 2, node 3, node 4. And node 1, node 2, node 3, node 4. The value of the matrix should be either 0 or 1. 0 represents there is no connection, and 1 represents there is a connection. If you look at it, 1 to 1, like this, the 1, you have to go this side and you have to come this side. Right? So 1, 1, where it means, it is 0 means, that is from 1 to 1, there is no connection. So it is 0. From 1 to 2, from 1 node to 2, there is a connection. So 1. From 1 to 3, there is no connection because 3 to 1 is only a connection is there. So 0. See, if you look at 3 and 1 here, 3 and 1, the value is 1. So accordingly, you have to fill the values 0 and 1. So I think you understand, students. So you have to draw a matrix. Like, let me draw it for this simple graph. A, B, C. Remember, this is a graph. There is a connection between A to B, C to A, and D, A to B. Now, how to draw a matrix A, B, C. Likewise, A, B, C. A to A, no connection, zero. A to B, yes, well, there is one connection, one. A to C, there is one connection, one. Next, B to B, zero. B to A, zero. B to B, also zero. B to C, also zero. Next, C to A, there is no connection, zero. C to B, yes, there is one connection, one. C to A, there is no connection, zero. So this is what you have to represent the graph in terms of a matrix. And that matrix is called adjacency matrix. Very, 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 very important to mark. A graph will be given to you and you are asked to represent the graph using a matrix. Next, adjacency list. So list is, if you here you have to treat the node one as the starting node, that is first node, then it has the connection between 2 and 4. So it has a connection between 2 and 4 as a set. Then 2 as a root node, then you should say it has another node 3. It has been connected. 3 is the node, it has a connection with 1. 4 is the node. So in detail, you can see here. So this is the graph. This is the graph for which that you have given. So you have been marked with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Likewise, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Sorry. 0. You should start with 0. 0, 1, 2, 3. Because 0 is there, right? 0. Up to 7, 6. Likewise, it goes on. Let me erase it. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Likewise, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 0 to 0, any connection? No. 0 to 1, yes, of course, there is a connection. So one should be here. 0 to 2, yes, one connection is there, right? One is there. 0 to 3, no connection. So 0 is there. 0 to 4, no connection. 0 to 5, no connection. 0 to 6, no connection. 0 to 7, no connection. So all are filled with 0. So likewise, you have to fill. But for adjacency matrix, you have to adjacency list, it has to be represented as a linked list kind of representation. So because it is a pointer implementation, so from 0, you have connection to 2 and 1. That is 1 and 2. 2 is made as null node. From 1, you have connection to 3 and 0. So 0 and 3. So likewise, you can read the rest. From 4, you have connection to 5. From 5, you have connection to 6. 4 and 6. So 4 connection is here. 6 and connection. From 6, you have connection 5 and 7. From 7, you have connection 6. So this is what adjacency list representation. So here some question has been given. What kind of question will be given to you is some graph is given. So based on the graph, you are asked to find out the adjacency list or the adjacency matrix. So in that aspect, you will be asked to find the concerned points for the matrix, for the given graph.